Today we'll be talking about capturing with Regex. We already know how grouping lets us group our Regex operations, but groups are also capturing by default. This means that anything that we group, we can capture and save into a variable. For example, in our first file, we've got a grouping around dot star, and so we'll capture any word that we find and save it into our first group. So for example, let's put in string number one. Then when we run it, we'll see our first group is love. And then if we change the string we're searching for, the other group we find is hate. And you can start to see how this might be useful. So if we extend this further, in our second file, we have the same pattern, but instead, we've got three groups. One group is around the dot star, the other group is around our course letters, and the other group is around our course code. So now we have our first string, which is I love COMP2041, and our second string, which is I love COMP1511. So if we run this, we've got groups 1 as love, group 2 as comp, and group 3 as 2041. And if we try and change the input, and we use group string 2 instead, now we have comp and 1511. You might start to hear how this is really useful if we want to do something like parse in a lot of strings and then try and find the things that we want to match for. Like you want to see if a bunch of students, what course codes and course numbers they have. Cool. And the way we do this is pretty simple. We take our pattern and our input string, we do a regex search on it, we get the match object, and then from the match object we can get the first, second, or nth group as we like. So what happens in a situation like this where we need to use a group around a repetition? So for example, our pattern here is the word B, or sorry, the letter B, with AN repeated multiple times. And this is just normal regex. We just want to find a string that has ANANANA like bananas. And you'll see how if we run this, we've got the whole match, which is banana, and then the first group is AN. And the way we've done this is if we specify no group, or just the zeroth group, we will get the entire match that our regex searched, or we will get, if we specify the group, we'll get the group that it's found. So in this case, AN. But now, let's look at our second file, or rather our fourth. We can use grouping around the groups to specify that we want to match the entire group. So for example, we've got our initial group here, which is the dot star, or rather AN star, and then a group around the group star. So now we're searching for any repetition of AN, ANA, AN, and then we're grouping that entirely. And so now, if we run this, we get our whole match being banana again, but then we get our first group, which is this one, to be the multiple repeating match of NA, or rather AN and AN, and then our second group, which is this one, which is just AN. And so here you might start to notice how, by order of left to right, we start to find, the groups. So if you want to know what number your group is, then you do something like, well, this is group 1, this is group 2, and then another group inside would be group 3. Okay, so the other thing you can do, if you're not a fan of grouping, is you can specify, I don't want this group to be capturing. And you can do that by putting the question mark colon. And so, in this case, our first group is the dot star, And our second group is the repetition of which we want. And so this is nice, since now we don't need to specify that we need to match a different group. We can just say, okay, this is my first group and this is my second group. And so now we get I like banana as the whole match, or I like as the second group, and NA, AN, AN as the third group. Cool. So there are many more ways we can use Regex scripts, but I hope that these few important ways will get you started. Thank you.